Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He always been faking me out.
Hey everyone, welcome to class today. Let's start as always with our student creed. Feet together, hands by your side. I'm a dedicated martial artist. Student creed begin. Yeah. I must develop myself in a positive manner and avoid anything that could reduce my mental growth or physical health. Number two, yeah, I must develop self-discipline in order to bring out the best in myself and others. Number three, yeah, I must use common sense before self-defense and never be abusive or offensive. Number four, yeah, winners never quit, quitters never win. I choose to be a winner. Number five, yeah, this is a black belt school. We are dedicated. We are motivated. We are on a quest to be our best. Asa, ready, set, courtesy. Congratulations to everyone who earned their stripe last week. Super excited to be starting a new month with you all. Just a reminder that if you're doing these videos, if you could please, please, please take pictures or take videos of yourself doing it, so that way we know that you're following along and you get credit for class. Also, if you have any feedback, I would love to hear how these are going for you, what things you like seeing, what things you want to see, what things you don't like. That way I can make a content that works best for you. All right, so definitely have an adult nearby to take pictures and videos, and definitely don't be afraid to reach out and let me know how you're liking the videos. So for our star sheet this month, our black belt lifestyle skill is the word modesty. Say modesty. And what modesty means is we want to have confidence, but we don't want to be conceited. We want to have a balance, and having that balance is modesty. So we want to be confident in our abilities, right? We want to, you know that we're strong, have pride in the work that we put into what we do. But we don't want to go around bragging about how awesome we are. We want to have pride in what we do, and we want to help other people learn and grow and have pride for other people too. So this month, we're going to have different challenges you could do and different ways that we can work on having that balance of being confident but not conceited. We want to be modest, all right? So think about that as we keep training for today. The stripe that you'll be getting this month is for intensity. Say intensity. Now, intensity is a physical way of showing our seriousness. So how serious we are about something, you can see in our bodies and in what we're doing. So that can be making a loud kia, having a really mean or serious face, or you can see in our muscles how we're making them strong when we're doing all the moves. Those are different ways that we can show intensity. And we're gonna be earning our red stripe for intensity. Red like fire, because fire burns really intensely. All right, so we're gonna go into a drill so we can practice that intensity, and you will be awesome. So we're gonna work on our intensity through our kicks. So last time we worked on accuracy. When we learn something new, we don't want to forget about the old things that we learned about. So we're going to bring a little bit of accuracy into us learning about intensity. And what we're going to do is a front kick. So again, whenever we do a kick, there's four parts. You guys are going to remember this until you turn 100 years old. You're going to always keep hearing it from me. Four parts to every kick. And that's chamber. Say that. Say chamber. Kick. Say kick. Rechamber. Say rechamber. Down, say down. So those are our four parts. When we do our front kick, just watch this first time and then we'll get to practice with me. For our front kick, when we are kicking, we're pointing our hips towards the target, which right now is the video, and we're bringing our legs straight up like we're stepping on a step for our chamber. All right, so when we do the chamber, our hips face the target and our knee comes up. That's the chamber. We kick, rechamber, and put our foot down. All right, so now you're gonna do it with me. Every time I say go, I want you to throw the kick. All right, I'm not gonna say chamber, kick, rechamber every time. I expect that since we worked on that last month, you can do that this month, all right, just when I say go. And then we'll press on the other side, and then we'll do the intensity drill. All right? Every time I say go, you're gonna kick, land forward, step back. Ready? Go! Yeah! And back. Go! Yeah! And back. Last one on this side, go! Yeah! And back. Now you're gonna switch your stance. We're doing the same thing on the other side. So the chamber looks the exact same, it's just with the other leg. Ready? Go! Yeah! Back. Go! Yeah! Back. Last one. Go! Yeah! And back. All right, so I key on every single time on my kick. And that's because we're working on intensity. So now I want you to add the kyos in. So if you did before, awesome. If you didn't, key on every time you're kicking. Now I know a lot of us are doing this, you know, at home in certain spaces. So if your adult is nearby and they're like doing work or you can't key off for some reason, that's okay. But if you are able to, I want you to start practicing. Two reasons. One, we key off to show intensity, but also we key off to remind us to breathe. When we say kia, we're taking our breath and we're exhaling. All right, a lot of the times when we're in stressful situations, we forget to breathe. So by kiaing, when we train, even though it might feel awkward or feel silly, it's training our bodies to remember to breathe if we were to ever be in a stressful situation. All right, so to work on intensity and to remind our bodies to breathe, we're gonna add kias in every time we kick. This is part one of our intensity drill. All right, so fall back into guard stance. Yeah! Same thing when I say go, you're gonna kick all four parts, land forward, step back, key on that kick. Ready? Go! Yeah! And back. Go! Yeah! And back. Go! Yeah! And back. Switch your stance, kia! Same thing on this side. Ready? Go! Kia! Oops, I forgot to land forward. Go! Kia! Last one on this side. Go! Kia! And time. So I said that was part one of the intensity drill. This is part two. A good example of this is I mentioned before, we're in our homes practicing martial arts. So there might be circumstances. Maybe you have a brother or sister that's younger that's taking a nap. Maybe your parent is working from home and they need it quiet, where you can't key out really loud, right? There's certain times where we don't need to be our full level of intensity, or we can't be our full levels of intensity. So we need to learn how to control our intensity and have it at different levels. So I'll give you an example. If I'm at a level one intensity, right? Let's say that I have a younger brother or sister that's sleeping and I can't wake them up, or I don't want to wake them up. I can still kia without waking up my sibling, right? I can say, yeah. All right, it's much quieter, it's under my breath, but I'm still kiaing to get that muscle memory to remember to breathe when I'm doing my techniques. I'm learning how to control my intensity. So that would be like a level one. A level three is somewhere in between. Maybe your brother and sister aren't sleeping, but your parents are doing something and you can't be at your level 10, you're super loud. So you're in between somewhere, right? You go, yeah. All right, so the yeah versus yeah. That's the difference between the level one and a level three. Or I should say level five, actually, because five is halfway between 10. So level one, level five, and then there's level 10, right? You have full range. You can bring your full intensity. This would be as loud as you can. You're thinking as if you need to do this technique, this kick, as if someone's trying to hurt you and you're trying to get also everybody's attention around. You want to scare off that person that's trying to hurt you, right? So level 10 would be like, ayah! So those are the levels of intensity that we're going to work with today. So what's going to happen is I'm going to throw on some music and you're going to listen for my voice. I'm going to say either level 1, level 5, or level 10, and that's the type of kick you're going to do. All right, you're the type of intensity level you're going to do with your kick. You're doing your back leg front kick. So try to find a space where you have some forward movement where you can go forward. So maybe back up away from the camera. So if I say one, you're coming forward with a front kick with your back leg, and you're doing level one intensity. So it'll be like, yeah. All right, then you wait for the next one for me to hear. You're gonna use your new back leg. Maybe I say 10, you go, yeah. Then you're waiting for the next one. You're gonna use your new back leg. I'll say 5. You're gonna say, yeah. Keep going as far as you can. If you have to back up and then start again, do that. I just wanna make sure that you're using both sides of your leg, both legs essentially. So you're practicing your kicks on both sides and you're practicing your control of intensity on both sides of your body. All right, so listen for my voice. I'm gonna throw on some music and let's get intense.
Level 10.
In the fading light, hearts collide.
Level 5.
Dance in the distance. Something just ain't right.
Level 1.
Cold inside. Help me find what I'm missing.
Level 5.
We're all scared to fly. Still we try.
Level 10.
Learn to be brave, see the other side. Don't you
level 10.
There. Have no fear.
Level 10.
Eyes find paradise.
Level 10.
Oh, my. There's a
level 5.
Between you and I.
Level 5. Level 1. Level 5.
There's a thousand miles between you and I.
Level 1. Level 10.
Between me and paradise.
Level 1. Level 10. Level 5. Level 10.
All right, so we're moving on to the forearms part of class for today. Before we go and practice the part of the forearm that we have for this week, we're going to talk about a specific technique called a spear. Say spear. And have you ever seen a spear before? If you have seen a spear, shout at the video. What does a spear look like? Tell me what a spear is. I'm sure you said a great example. If you don't know what a spear is, and just so we're all on the same page, a spear is a weapon that can be used, for example, like in fishing. If you're like fishing in the water instead of with a fishing pole, there's normally some sort of long stick. And then at the end of the long stick, it looks like a little triangle and the triangle's sharp. And the tip of the triangle is what stabs. So that's what we're talking about when we talk about a spear. In our form, we have a move called spear hand. So we're making our hands spears. We want to think about our hands being the little triangle at the end of the spear that is sharp and pointy. So go ahead and go like this, make a really tight hand like this. So your fingers are all together, your thumb is tucked to the side like this. It's not in front. Not behind, if you can get your thumb behind. It's next to, but just kind of tucked there. All right, and you're thinking about, so this is my spear hand. I'm gonna show you things with this other hand. This part is the spear that stabs into your target. So your spear might come in this way, it might come in this way, it might come in this way. Either way, this pointy part right here, that's the top of your spear. So go ahead, put both your spear hands up. Let me see them like this. Good, now put one down. Point to the spear pointy part on the hand that you kept up. Good, now put them both back up. Put the other one down. Point to this the pointy spear part of this one. Good. All right, so when I say spear hand, that's what I'm talking about. There's gonna be different ways that we strike with our spear. So we wanna think about if we are hitting someone in the eyes, right? Like someone who doesn't have glasses, because if you did that, you'd just hit their glasses. They don't have glasses on. You're going to take your spear hand and you're going to point them down so you're like the palm part of your hand is facing down. And you're going to poke towards the eyes. You can do it like your own eye level. So do this with me. Make your spear hand. I'm going to say eyes. You're going to go eyes, eyes. Ready? Go. Eyes, eyes. Good. Let's do that again. Bring your spear hands up. Eyes, eyes, eyes. I was supposed to say go, not eyes. Try that again. Spear hands up. Go. Eyes, eyes. Good. One more time together. Spear hands up. Go. Eyes, eyes. Nice. And we're going to do one more spear hand technique today before we hop into our form. And this time we're going to take our spear hands. We're going to point the palm in towards each other so that you could like smack your hands like this. And what you're thinking about is you're thinking about taking your spear hand and putting it in someone's throat here. This is kind of touching your own throat. We can see it's kind of like soft right here. That's where you're thinking about stabbing your spear hands. So when I say go, this time on your own throat level, you're gonna throw your two spear hands in there. Ready? And you're gonna say throat, throat. Ready? Go, throat, throat. Good. And again, go, throat, throat. Good. Last time, ready? Go, throat, throat. Let's see if you remember. We're gonna go back to eyes. So when I say eyes, you're gonna flip your hands so they're facing down, and then you're gonna do your eyes, ready? Eyes, eyes, eyes. Good, now flip your hands in, throat, throat, throat. Good. So that's what we're doing when I say spear hands to the eyes. We're doing eyes, eyes, our palms are facing down, we're striking with that sharp part of our spear hand. When I say throat, our palms are always facing in, and we're striking with this sharp part of our spear hand. All right, so now you know your spear hand techniques. Let's jump into learning what part of our form we're doing this week. All right, so feet together, hands by our side. Action karate form two, part B, ma'am. And this time, instead of jumping into a guard stance, we're gonna bring both our hands forward like an X. I'm gonna come close so you can see. Come like this. We're gonna jump into a horse stance. As we do that, our hands come across and we're gonna elbow backwards. So they start as an X in front. Do this with me, do X in front and then bring them back. Pretend like you're taking your elbow when you're trying to hit something behind you. All right? So when we go into guard stance, that's what we're doing with a horse stance. So let's actually start from the beginning again. Action karate form two, part B, ma'am. Horse stance, yeah. Move number one. We're doing two spears to the eyes. So one, eyes, eyes. Good, and two, throat, throat. And feet together. That's all we're working on this week. Because we want to make sure that we have those moves down. So one is eyes, eyes. Two is throat, throat. And it's also important when you're doing this to hold it out there at the end until the next move comes. Whatever hand you're not using is pulled back in a chamber. All right, so it's just like this, it's ready to be used. And lastly, I know that it gets confusing with the video a little bit because it might be mirror image. So the hand that you start with should be your right hand. All right, this is my right hand. It might look like the left to you. So make sure that you're using your right hand. And if you have to ask an adult to help you, make sure you do that, okay? So one more time together. Feet together, hands by your side. Action karate form two, part B, ma'am. Horse stance, yeah. One, eyes, eyes. Two, throat, throat. Set, victory, humility. Courtesy, ma'am, give yourself a hand. All right, so what's gonna happen is you're gonna see me on the screen and we're gonna practice together. So there'll be music playing. We're gonna do the form over and over and over again with the music. All right, this will give us time for our bodies to build muscle memory and for us to get better every single time. And I want you to be practicing at a level 10 intensity the whole time, if you can. If your, you know, baby brother or sister sleeping or your adult is working, then maybe do a level 1. So your discretion, but my challenge for you, if you can, is to do a level 10. All right, so you're gonna see me come on the screen and I'm gonna be doing this form over and over again.
My mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments. I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich. Throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. 713. Through the 281, yeah, I'm riding. Why they on me? Why they on me? I'm flying. Sipping low key. I'm sipping low key at Onyx. Find a rider. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. You come around, yeah. You ease my mind. You make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments. I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich. Throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah.
All right, so we're moving on to the self-defense portion of class today. Your self-defense is two-hand choke with a block, chilson block, to be specific. So what that means is you're bringing your hands up to break the choke versus a two-hand choke with a pluck like we've done in the past. So a two-hand choke with a break, I should say. So someone's choking you like this. You're always going to start with hands up and you say, I don't want any trouble. You're going to shoot your hands straight up like this. And then you're going to take your elbows and you're going to pretend you're dropping them on someone's arms. So you broke the choke. Then you're going to push them away. Then you're going to punch, you're going to punch, you're going to kick, and then you're going to cover out. So you're going to do one step, two step, yeah. So let's do that again, a little more gracefully, less goofy. I'm a little goofy today, I apologize. Hands up, I don't want any trouble. Someone's choking you, shoot your hands straight up. Ah, that's why, I forgot the step back. So you're going to, as you drop down, you're going to step back, drop your weight. Then with the leg that's back, that's the hand that's going to punch. Then you're going to kick, land forward. And you're going to do one step, two step, yeah. So let's do that again. See, this is where, see, I'm going to bring the black belt lifestyle skill in again. It's important to have confidence in ourselves and our ability, but it's important to be humble and be honest. Now, I'm a black belt who has been doing karate for more than half my life. But I make mistakes. And I'm going to own those mistakes, and I'm going to grow from those mistakes. And we're going to get to grow together from the mistake I just made. So two-hand choke, hands up. I don't want any trouble. Your hands come up. You're going to drop your elbows down. You're going to step back slightly. And as you drop your elbows down, you drop your weight down like this. Then that backhand, the foot that's slightly back is going to punch. That back foot is going to do a front kick, land forward, and then you're going to cover out. One step, two step, yeah. Alrighty, last time together, I'll break it down, and then you'll have some time to practice. Hands up, I don't want any trouble. Hands come straight up, you're going to step back, then you're going to drop your weight. You're going to punch, you're going to do a back leg front kick, land forward, and then you're going to cover up. One step, two step, yeah. And time. All right, so to practice, it's going to be similar to your form. You're going to see me hop on the screen. I'm going to be doing the self-defense. You're following along, doing it with me. We're practicing it over and over and over again so that we get it down and we become stronger together. All right, so check out the screen, follow along with me, and do your best.
Think about you, you know that I have all gonna lose.
Portion of class today. Remember, weapon is something we need to respect, so we're not just whipping it around and horse playing with it. We also want to respect the home we live in and the things around us, so make sure you're in a space where you're not going to break anything. Make sure you check in with your adult. We want to respect our adults as well, and make sure it's okay to use the weapon. If it's not, you can just pretend you have the weapon in your hand and go along with the hand motions just the same. All right, this week we're working on triangle whip. So what we're going to do, as always, we hold our weapon right up close to the connecting part. So for me, it's a chain. For you, it would be a string, probably. We're going to put it on our shoulder. Now, we're going to make a triangle across our body. So we're going to take it from the shoulder on our right side down to the hip on our left side. Then you're going to bring it to the hip across on your right side. And then you're back up to your shoulder. So as you can see, I'm going to hold my chest for a second. We're making a triangle here, all right? That's why it's called triangle whip. So when I say one, you're gonna go to your first hip side. So from your right shoulder to your left hip. Two is gonna be from your left hip to your right hip. And three is gonna be from your right hip up back up to your right shoulder. Ready? One, two, three. Good, and even if you already have done this before, take it slow and break it down with me. I don't want you whipping it and getting ahead. All right, we're working together. We're staying together. One, two, three. One more time like that. One, two, three. Again, bringing modesty back into this. You might have seen this before. You might have done this before. But we can always grow and get better. So it's great that you already know it. And that's so awesome. Be confident, be proud of that, but be humble, be modest, and know that there's pieces that when you break things down slowly, it'll help you get even better. All right, but now what I'm gonna say is go, and you're gonna do that whole thing. So it looks like this. Ready? Go. 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 Good, and we're bringing in from last month. We're gonna reach across, pull it out. Now we're gonna put it on the other side. And just a reminder, to put it on our shoulder, the shoulder that we wanna go to is the elbow that comes across and makes a muscle. The other hand goes underneath, and you put it up on your shoulder. You let go with the hand that's across your belly. So same thing on this side. One is gonna be, now you're going from your left shoulder to your right hip. Two is gonna be from right hip to left hip. Three is gonna be from left hip to left shoulder. Ready? One, two, three. One, two, three. Last time, slow. One, two, three. All right, now I'll say go. You can do that whole thing together. Go. 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 Good, then you're gonna come across your belly, grab. Pull it out, put them together, and that is our weapon for class. So we're gonna end class together, feet together, hands by our side. Repeat after me. I'm a dedicated student of the martial arts. And I live by the principles of being a black belt. And they are integrity, concentration, perseverance, respect and obedience, self-control, humility, indomitable spirit, knowledge, power, black belt, courtesy. Give yourself a hand. Excellent work today.